In a notice released by the U.S. Internal Revenue Service in the U.S. government website early February, the name Perfecto Rivas Yasay Jr. was included in the list of former Americans who recently renounced their U.S. citizenship. But during his confirmation hearing at the Senate Wednesday last week, the Foreign Affairs Secretary maintained that he never was a U.S. citizen.
I did not abandon my citizenship in the Philippines. So there is no inconsistency in so far as my having taken an oath and my losing citizenship on that basis.
Yasay admitted that he applied for U.S. citizenship and even swore allegiance to the United States. He said he did not qualify for U.S. citizenship because he planned to abandon the U.S. and move back to the Philippines. But documents that Congresswoman Josephine Sato claims she obtained from Yasay himself tell a different story. Among them is Yasay's own affidavit, which states that he did obtain American citizenship back in 1986.
He was granted a U.S. citizenship by virtue of his petition number 12831295, mm-hmm. which he filed before the U.S. District Court of New Jersey. Mm-hmm. So it's very clear that he was granted in 1986 mm-hmm. U.S. citizenship.
Yasay also included a certificate of loss of nationality of the United States issued to him after formally renouncing his U.S. citizenship at the U.S. Embassy in Manila on June 28, 2016, or 2 days before his appointment as Foreign Affairs Secretary.
I will confront him with his own documents and maybe make him explain why he lied to us in saying he categorically stated that he was never an American citizen, when in fact all this really proved that he was at some point in time.
For U.S.-based immigration lawyer attorney Lou Tansinko, this act of renunciation is clear proof that he was indeed an American citizen.
You cannot say you never had the citizenship when you went before a consular officer and renounced it. Mm-hmm. What are you renouncing?
Because of his lies, Congressman Sato says she'll vote not to confirm Yasay as DFA secretary. Senator Ping Lacson, meanwhile, says Yasay's confirmation should be the least of the secretary's concerns as he could be liable for perjury.
That could be a cause for a complaint for perjury, you know, if it can be proven na nag-lie siya at authentic yung mga dokumento.
Malacanang has said it is content with Yasay's explanation and his citizenship is a non-issue.
Mr. Yasay has already made a very credible and logical, reasonable response regarding the matter.
Secretary Yasay is set to face the Commission on Appointments again next week. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.